Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I am chairman of the session, speakers and audience. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I am thankful to IOS for giving me a chance to be here and to speak on this occasion. My topic today is the significance of Islam for social justice and peace in the contemporary world. This lecture is divided into these areas: introduction, economic crisis of the world, why the present economic crisis, role of Islamic social system in making justice in the past, Muslim intellectual decline, how to revive the situation, and last of all, conclusion. Firstly, we can say that human society and civilization is facing tremendous challenges and struggle in a capitalistic, selfish world order. Practice of capitalism has embedded materialism and selfishness in human life. At any cost, new generation is determined to achieve a materialistic goal, keeping moral concern ignored. As a result, we have got a society where 50% of world population is controlled by only a dozens of industrialists. Only practice of religion can transform human mind from selfishness to selflessness, from aggressive to a submissive and accommodative mind. The teachings of Islam are time-tested for time immemorial in this regard. Now we come to the economic crisis of the world. World's income distribution gives a very sad picture. 94% of the world income goes to 40% of the population, while 60% of people live on only 6% of world income. Half of the world population lives on $2 a day. Over 1 billion of people live on less than $1 a day. Now, why the present economic crisis? In fact, 13th century was a Renaissance society. People were moving away from the preoccupation with religion. Secularization is extremely dangerous to the Muslim Ummah because secularization disconnects worldly aspect from the spiritual one. In this regard, Muslims shake and decline to accept the process of westernization and secularization in the name of invention and progress. Muslim thinkers and politicians experimented with various Western ideologies for 3/4 of a century with unsuccessful results. The frequent failure of the Muslim leaders to implement socially beneficial policies has led to deterioration. And this has caused class polarization and conflict in populations with unequal growth rates. And secularization happens in the name of science, progress, humanism, modernization, and so forth. The immediate outcome of such secularism is capitalism, and one of the reasons of world poverty is the dominance of capitalism. Now we come to Islamic economic system in making social justice, the role of Islamic economic system. In fact, Islamic economics concentrates on spiritual welfare. It generally ignores on the other hand, secular and materialistic worldview generally ignores the importance of spiritual aspect. And Islamic economics concentrates on spiritual welfare of the society, which ultimately includes nearness to God, peace of mind, honesty, justice, mutual care, and cooperation. And there is an integrated role of the market here. Market, family, society, government here. And also another aspect of Islamic economics is that it gives emphasis on the importance of the hereafter. Some of the contributions which were made by Islamic economics. The focus of Islamic economics is on human well-being, not economic variables. And justice is the pivotal place in this whole framework. And there is the concentration of division of labor, demand and supply, taxation, etc. And the contributions made by different scholars over the centuries seem to have reached their consummation in Ibn Khaldun's Muqaddimah. But there was a decline, we see. If we go through the history, we see that there was a decline in a Muslim intellectual level. And in this regard, we can say that the contribution made by Muslim scholars up until Ibn Khaldun did not get fertilized and irrigated by later scholars. The reason behind it that the political and socio-economic decline of the Muslim world was underway. Then conventional economics became a separate academic discipline after the publication of Alfred Marshall's great treatise, Principles of Economics. And conventional economics took a wrong turn after the Enlightenment movement. But there is also hope. This has been changing. The role of good governance has already been recognized. Moral values is gradually penetrating the economics orthodoxy. Islamic economics is also reviving now after the independence of Muslim countries from foreign domination. Last of all, we can suggest some points which ultimately help to revive the past situation. First of all, Muslims should be reminded of their responsibility to be a model and lead the world for the establishment of social justice in accordance with Islamic principles and wisdom. Secondly, throughout the world, distribution problems generated by the capitalist system have triggered various economic, political, social, and intellectual crises. For that reason, the mainstream economic system and thought should be criticized more, doing that alternatives for a new system should also be emphasized more strongly. Number three, today one of the most significant reasons of social injustice is usury. In usury-based economic systems, welfare is transferred only to a specific minority group in the whole society. For that reason, studies should be improved in order to usury problems to be clearly identified, and this should be done by the Muslim intellectuals. Number four, today economists offer the method of tax as a solution for income injustices. On the other hand, Zakat offers a more comprehensive and systematic solution to this problem. And in this framework, Zakat institution should be paid more attention as a way to the solution. We should not rely only on the traditional distribution of Zakat by the hand of individuals. Systems that are developed in various countries to collect, distribute and utilize Zakat in an effective and productive way should be examined. WAF is an interest-free institution based upon charity and aids. The contribution of a WAF to social welfare and justice should be evaluated on a broader and a deeper framework today. In addition, new models and practices of WAFs should be improved. Then infaq and sadaqa culture in Islam should be remembered in today's societies in line with the Islamic principles of social aid. Last of all, we conclude that this reunification, if reinforced, can help promote peaceful society, and this will enable mankind to realize the well-being of all. This is the realization of which we are all anxiously looking forward to. Thank you.